Good morning, everyone. My name is Pooja Ghumre. I'm from Platform 9 Systems, and I have here with me.
Hi, my name is Sampath. I'm from NTT.
So we are here to talk about zero-touch high availability for your OpenStack virtual machines using Masakari and Consul. So here's a quick look at today's agenda. I'll give you a brief introduction about what Platform 9 Systems does and what is the need for VMHA today and the current status of OpenStack project called Masakari. Then we'll touch upon Platform 9's zero-touch solution to address that problem and what is the future work that we are addressing in our roadmap. So Platform 9 Systems was founded in 2013 by a bunch of ex-VMware engineers. We started our journey with a SaaS-managed OpenStack, and today we also offer the same for Kubernetes. We also recently introduced a project called Fission, which basically allows you to have serverless functions as a service on top of Kubernetes. So this is all remotely managed, so we're basically a remotely managed hybrid cloud since we also support public clouds like AWS or GCP in our environment. We work with any hardware or platform that you may already have, so your existing KVM, vSphere, or Docker environment can easily integrate with Platform 9. So one of the main advantages of being SaaS managed is that we can provide 24/7 monitoring of your infrastructure. So we take care of the entire lifecycle from deployments until seamless upgrades, and we help you with all the troubleshooting issues as well. So that's that about Platform 9, and now we'll switch gears to VMHA.
Okay, thank you, Pooja. This is about, I'm going to explain about what is high availability for the VMs. And I'm not going to go for more details because we have been giving so many talks about this summit and the previous summits, and you can refer those talks or the discussions, and we have, end of the presentation, we have slides called the related topics. But for simply, what is high availability for the VMs is like, especially when you run any traditional workloads in your clouds, you want to provide some SLA to your users, and you have to make sure that the VM's not going to disappear one day suddenly. So those VMs can disappear due to a lot of reasons like the host failures, the KVM failures, and process failures. And the high availability is the rescue or resurrect those VMs from those failures. So we have been giving so many talks in this summit about with a lot of details about these topics. And we have this long argument about kettles and pets, about the clouds. So this solution is basically targeted for the pets, but not only for the pets. You may use these solutions also for the kettles, like kind of an alternative recovery mechanism. So, and also we have doing a lot of works on the instance HA and the control plane HA in the OpenStack. You may refer to the HA documentations about how to configure your cloud with the high availability. And we also have these specs and user stories also define what are the use case of this HA plane. And this is the rough architecture of the Masakari. This is a project we started in the GitHub like 2 years ago, and now we see under the OpenStack namespace. The Masakari team has doing a great job about to make it to the OpenStack standards, and we have now the API and the engine. Those are the main components of the Masakari, and still you have the Python Masakari client, which give you a nice CLI to control everything. And we have three basic monitors to monitor process failures and instance failures and the host failures. And by the way, you can configure it with the Consul or Pacemaker or any other HA solution you have. And so we have a lot of configurations, and it's highly configurable. So you can refer further details in the Masakari Wiki. You just can go to Google and search Masakari Wiki, then you will hit our page. So you may find more details in there. So I'm going to skip the rest of the details here because we have limited time. So I'm going to go back to Pooja about the Cloud 9.
Okay, thanks, Apat. So let's look at what's the Platform 9 solution. So we talked about using Masakari to recover from a node failure. But before we get to that, the first step towards that is detecting that there's a failure in your system and reconfiguring your system once you know that a node has gone down or a new node has joined your cluster, right? So for detecting host failures, we use Consul. I'll talk more about that. Now you have Consul and Masakari for failure detection and recovery. So the missing piece here is any of these clustering services that you may use for detecting failures, they need admin intervention when something goes wrong. And that is a problem today that we are trying to address. So Platform 9 offers this zero-touch solution where we basically automatically reconfigure your HA cluster when a node goes down or when a new node is added to your availability zone. And keep in mind that when I say zero touch, it does not mean zero downtime. This is still a traditional workload, and you have to expect that there will be a minimal downtime for recovering from that failure and evacuating the VMs. So as I said, we chose Consul. It's a tool developed by HashiCorp, which allows you to do service discovery and health monitoring. We chose this tool because it's very simple to set up, and it has this inherent capability that it requires minimal admin involvement. So apart from service discovery and monitoring, it also provides you a key value store, which you can use for leader election that Consul relies on. So it basically uses two protocols. One is the gossip protocol, and there is a consensus protocol. As you can see in this diagram, there's multiple nodes in your data center. So these are all, think of them as hypervisors running Consul agent in either client mode or server mode. All of these nodes are participating in what is called the gossip protocol, which helps it with discovering a failed node. And the server nodes, there's also a leader amongst the server nodes, which is basically responsible for handling all the transactions and replicating the state to follower server nodes. So, in Consul, the consensus requires a quorum of at least n by 2 plus 1 servers, so that defines your fault tolerance. So if you have 3 servers, you can tolerate 1 failure. If you have 5 servers, you can tolerate 2 failures. So you can set up your environment in that way. So we have all these building blocks now, and how do they come together? So we added this service called Platform 9 HA Manager. So the top 3 services are basically part of your control plane. And HA Manager is what is responsible for automatically reconfiguring your HA cluster. So if you have a Nova availability zone, you can say enable HA. And that would basically create a cluster within Consul. So that HA Manager pushes cluster configuration to this HA slave component that is running on all the hypervisor nodes. And HA slave is basically a helper service for Consul, which identifies whether it should be running in client mode or server mode. Also, as you can see, the requirement here is that all the KVM hypervisors should be using a shared storage so that Nova can evacuate once you notify Masakari that a node has failed and it needs to be recovered. So some of the items in the future roadmap include handling simultaneous node failures. So basically, when you're reconfiguring a cluster, that's a time window where you cannot monitor any new host failures. So you need to handle that. That's something we're working on. Apart from that, monitoring service and instance health. So we are currently looking at compute nodes going down, but an individual instance or a service on that host can also go down. So we need to address those failures as well.
Yeah, of course. In Masakari side, we were so much focused on the coding last few years, and it's kind of a lack of documentation at the moment, but we have minimum documentation. But right now we are working for the more detailed documentation for Masakari. It's kind of our very prioritized item for this release. And also we have this spec called the recovery method customization, which is give you a highly configurable the interface to the configure your customer recovery workflows, such as like in the node failure, right now we only have the evacuation, but you may configure it to like send a mail to operator before the evacuation and send another mail to operator like after the evacuation, says okay, I'm finished with the evacuation. This is kind of one example, but you can combine a lot of recovery methods in your workflow. And also we looking forward to getting the Big Ten because it will give you a lot of advantages for users and also the Masakari community, and it will be a nice thing to have. Okay, it's about the summary.
Yeah, so just to summarize, we are using our distributed consensus protocol for monitoring the state of your HA cluster, which allows you to recover even traditional workloads similar to how you're used to with your cattle. And basically the idea is to eliminate any admin intervention, so you get a seamless experience with that. And most of our vSphere customers are basically quite used to this feature, so this gives you an equivalent functionality on the KVM side as well. These are some of the links that you can take a look at. We have a VMHA demo on YouTube that you can check out. There's also links for Masakari and Consul documentation. Also the PF9 HA project, which includes the HA manager and HA slave services I talked about. It's part of an open source project, so you can go check out that code and contribute if you can. If you have any questions or comments, I think we don't have time, yeah, but we'll be at the back if you have any, and we can address those. Thank you.
Thank you very much.